proposed ban on assault rifles debated at City Hall. Good evening, I'm Stephanie Gorin.
And I'm George Mallet. A crowd punctuated with bits of blaze orange filled Contois Auditorium at Burlington City Hall tonight. Seems hunters wanted to have their say as the council considers a ban on assault rifles.
That debate is largely symbolic, as a ban would still require a public vote and legislative backing. News Channel 5's David Charnes is just back from City Hall with the story tonight. David.
Well, City Council just passed this resolution 10-3. It says there's no need for assault rifles and high-capacity magazines in Burlington, and that's something not sitting well with gun owners.
Everything we've done so far hasn't worked, so it's time to try something different.
Gun rights supporters crowd into Burlington City Hall, aiming to convince City Council to table a proposed ban on assault weapons.
Because these people pick up a stick, a rock, or they'll use their fists. You're going to cut everybody's hands off?
No supporters of the charter change spoke Monday night.
Resolution is so overly broad that you'd be illegalizing most of the rifles and certainly most of the handguns in the city of Burlington.
Police Chief Michael Sherling says most gun crime in the city involves handguns, not assault weapons, a message echoed in the crowd.
How many semi-automatic rifles have been shot in the city of Burlington and people injured? None. How many large-capacity magazines in those rifles were used? None.
Councillor Norm Blay proposed the resolution. He says its purpose is to protect Burlington citizens and to make the city's gun laws as safe as those followed by hunters.
That we should afford to the same sort of common sense in the streets that we have in the woods. And that we should afford to our citizens, especially our children, the same rights that we give to our deer.
Opponents of the charter change say banning guns isn't the way to go. Instead, some argued Burlington should do more to open up recreational gun use inside its borders.
Giving people an outlet for the firearms they currently do have is more appropriate than scaring people from firearms.
There's a long road ahead if this were to ever become law. A subcommittee will look at the charter proposal and write up new language. Then voters would weigh in on the issue in 2014. The state legislature would then have to vote yes before it became part of the city's charter. Live in the newsroom tonight, I'm David Charnes, News Channel 5 Nightcast.